And with that, we go into track number four. Since I'm already talking, I might just open this up. The name of the song is When We're Dancing Close and Slow. I was privileged, is the word I'll use, to witness a live performance of this at North Sea Jazz in July 2011, a great moment on that little tour. And Andy Ullo joined him on the vocals there. It was seduction supreme that night when they did this song. A surprise live outing for this track too. But back to the studio version. Toe-Jam, you said that there's parts of Sexy Dancer that you don't want to play when people are in your car. Depending on who you've got in your car, this could be a great song to play, or it could be entirely the wrong song for the wrong moment. Because this isn't filthy. This is just sassy, sensual, almost erotic, I would say. It's got this haunting quality with a lovely guitar strumming and the piano flourishes. Really haunting, really eerie, really soothing in a strange way. A very emotive song. I love this as well. To me, this is classic Prince production on this album. It's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Great tracks. And we're not even at the halfway point. And with that, let's go to Captain.
We all knew the 1, 2, 3 round of killer tracks. It couldn't last forever. That's when we get to track 4.
Oh, God.
What are we going to do with you, Captain?
Damn.
This is the first ballad on the album. It's got some nice acoustic guitars, and then a second one comes in later on doing some stuff, and they sound really nice. It's not my favorite track of the album, but there's some cool stuff in there. But the funniest part of this track is when Monkey calls his flying cloud. Best part in the whole song. It happens like 3 or 4 times.
Say what?
I know what he's talking about.
What?
Toe-Jam knows what I'm talking about. That's the best bit in the whole song. Who knows Monkey? Toe-Jam knows Monkey. Monkey magic.
Monkey
Magic.
Oh, yeah, I know Monkey Magic. What's
Japanese
that got to do with
story,
this?
Japanese story, Journey to the West. He calls his, in the TV series, he used to do this thing and he'd call his flying cloud. And it's not exactly the same, but it always reminds me of that every time I hear it. It's at 158, it's again at 423, and then a couple more times. Do you know what I'm talking about, MC?
I actually don't know what you're talking about.
I have no idea, either.
But I do know Monkey Magic, so yeah. It's been a while.
He had a flying cloud, and he used to call it by making this stupid wind sound.
All right, we're out of control now. We are officially out of control. I gotta get you back into
the... Yeah, that's the best bit in this whole song. It's my favorite part. Just when those weird synth sounds come in as well at about 4:23. I think the thing that saves this song for me is the drums. I think without them, it'd be a pretty boring song. It'd sound too slow. But the drums there keeps the tempo going, keeps me interested. And I think this would be a great song to do if he ever wants to do like some sort of unplugged thing with just acoustic guitars. Keep it short, 2 or 3 minutes. It'd be really nice. Get Andy McKee back. It'd be killer. Just get those two. Listen to the last minute of this song and imagine Prince and Andy jamming on this. That'd be good.
I didn't want to butt in, but Captain, you just blew my mind. I can't believe with Andy McKee in the band, now that I think of it, they didn't do this.
How did they not?
This would have been an Andy McKee showcase.
It would have been great.
And instead he's like strumming away to mountains and no one can hear anything he's playing. Some things will never be explained.
Pretty much.
Player, what are your thoughts on this song?
Oh man, how good is this song?
What?
This is very dreamy and hypnotic. The piano and guitar are highlights musically. The drums keep a consistent, steady beat that remains all the way through. I agree with you there, Captain. The lyrics are great. Some of the ones are, I can almost taste the thoughts within your mind. And the straight out, I want to come inside you. You know, he's just laying it out there. It's just classic.
I haven't heard that bit.
Yeah, yeah.
It's because you don't listen to lyrics,
the whole
Captain.
Song.
So
yeah,
you've got
exactly.
to start listening to the lyrics. He writes them down for a reason, you know.
It's just classic, and 4 songs in, and the material's really strong. And as you said, MC, he brought this back live at North Sea Jazz, and it just makes me wonder why he doesn't revisit this one more often. And I also agree with the last minute with the acoustic guitars and the keyboard. It sounds like it's sort of springing around everywhere in the headphones when I listen to it. It's really cool. Yeah.
Monkey magic.
Yes, it is cool. And speaking of cool, here's the man himself, Toe-Jam. Round out this review of When We're Dancing Close and Slow.
It's one of those songs that if you're just listening to it, you know, in the car, you might skip it. But if you're all alone and you've got your headphones on, it's a really nice song, isn't it? It's all about the atmosphere. It's all very subtle. It's in the mode of B Lydian. So an interesting key, interesting mode. obviously that sort of, I don't know what you call it, that do-do-do-do, those kind of four notes, always reminded me of, you know, the closing, you know, in Close Encounters of the Third Kind, how it has that little do-do-do-do-do. It always reminded me of that. It's like, oh, Prince is calling the aliens.
On their flying clouds.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's just a nice little interesting, and again, it's sort of those sort of that, Prince dreamy songs that, you know, it's this very unique atmosphere to it. And like we've all said, at from about 3 minutes 39, the guitars in the background start becoming a bit more rhythmic. There's a bit more synth effects going on. And it's sort of, it's almost like being outside at night and suddenly you start noticing the crickets chirping. You know, you notice that there's more things there than there were before. So it's a nice little effect. But it can be a little bit skippable if you're not really in the mood for it.
That thing that you're talking about, the Close Encounters, it actually kind of sounds like the line in Ice Cream Castles.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Same sort of idea, yeah.
Same, yeah.
Okay,
you know,
okay.
You know what this also sounds like is on the Truth album, you had mostly acoustic stuff with a bunch of weird sound effects chucked over the top of it. It all started here. Actually, or did it start on 4U? I think on 4U he had the death laser on 4U.
Crazy You. Yeah, it was on Crazy You.
Yeah. He had, you know, Star Wars going on in there. And here again, he's got this gets the sound effects out. He loves that, like, concept. Let's do a nice just guitars and vocals and sound effects too. That'll make it so much better. Classic. MC,